但英国人呢，这个没有像这个也是这个我都个吃的呢，对么？但这个没，因那样啊，你那个长得的刚那有那样，对待这个下酒的，我认为呢，他的主办人，但对你呢，回那我吃给我爸个，对你拉拢跟着这呢，我爸个，用胳膊让我用的，对待这个钱坑当的，起码对那我们的用的，当时呢，对你家那个回那旧木的呢，家那个渣了。那这个呢，那么看不看不的，空的这个让多个，等你们多学个，差嘛些个呢，我嘛些个呢，差嘛些多个用的嘞。但是呢，我学个用的，绝对得有些多个用的。但这村这个，等你我做，南华的啦，经济学呢，但粮食类那些呢，总的，我们人的这个人类的啰嗦这个自己认为的呢，当咱们这个，等你这个。罗雄书记的，娘娘书记，各个嘛都在嘛。人口个这个代表青年子个，就是大名的子的，代表青年子个，二名的咱们子的，代表青年子的这个人口个，他这个各些个大这个人民学院的咱们这个这个南华山这边出生的这个努力爬过去个，干那样啊，学到那里，学了单背样嘛，多呢啊，这个学了没等把咱们一地通个旮旯子用着，其实在那学了那单背样。这个上级的秋子记得多干的人那几个，两把出人那地通这个还真是干个都怂恿的。但对等这样的，我说这个长马个，实在工作就双路等个起来，我但那长马个人际学记得，这个也是人把人的烂的人把打的人际学记得那罗雄学记，娘们学记那个些个三个哟。
Now, I'm not saying this because someone else said it and I'm repeating their idea. And when I speak from my own understanding of what is true and correct that I've observed. And hopefully it is, in fact, the true condition that I'm presenting. And so, for example, at our monastic college in Tibet, we have, from the time that it began until now, continued to teach Dharma according to these five categories of study of sutra that I just mentioned. And then that is followed by the subsequent studies in mantra. And as a result of that, over the years, there are many Chinese students who have become monastics, monks and nuns, and also lay people who have gone through this curriculum and accomplished it, many of them becoming Kenpos and Kenmos. That means scholars, Fulbright scholars, male and female, who have achieved these accomplishments, and they are capable, fully qualified to teach, just like their Tibetan lamas taught them. And so, if you really look closely at what has been accomplished by the Chinese people due to the efforts of this process that we've presented for them, then their knowledge that they are gaining and that which is being produced is not only of highest value, but is extremely profound. This is quite unlike reading a few Dharma books and then claiming to know about Buddha Dharma, translating a few books and claiming to be a translator of Buddha Dharma, or just analyzing some of the topics in a class and then considering oneself to be learned on the subject. And then Ken Rinpoche gave a quote from the Sutra Palpoche, which speaks about this subject. And so we have to think carefully about how important it is in the Buddhist tradition, just as it is with any study or attempt to learn, that this needs to be approached gradually and systematically so that one can actually really have a strong foundation in training and knowledge to accomplish the goal.
Kasang dana girgan garega chu bopa chamchada chu chirtar shane ya thamchada chu chirtar shane to sungdu ta shirna bopa zeki da chi tapa yha yon re chong chong de tapa yha yon re yinna ya rap to shong gare ma to chama yige me shin ta mo yon re ta janu kum so yinna a chi chong chong de ge ne yike shim kum mo yon re re ta ne ngi ngun yinna a ta mulo samchi ge ranga ta ri ga Tani wodanyang akzo ngimjong da shangchip ka sem wadagme kartawa. Ndi tsu akzo yidana daga shati wata yin. Tani dyanag ka tariga mo tamchit yin na yang akzo wata yin. Ta mo mongbo ga nga la tani nzambala ga tariga wang shkir goga. Tani tsir rang shkir ga tariga wang shkir goga zi. Tani nga wang shkiram ma shi tar shkir mamnyo. 체랑 찍게 원할 거 마음요. 르지어 찍게 원할 거 마음요. 다때 이거 천디 땅아 아 드베 톱네요. 다 못 톱네요. 당다나. 그럼 따리요는 뜨거 응책이 철업 모즈 그런 상황 거디 대지니 사바즈감 통금이 대니 나다가 아 다 정거다가 냠뇨 다 그렇게 샤네나 다 파르치르티문르즈레.
There are teachers on this tour, educators who have asked me, how is it that you would teach differently to the Chinese versus the Tibetans? What might that difference be? Well, I would have to say that these days in modern, the Tibetans in China, at the present time, still do have faith in Dharma inherently. But except for those who become monastics and go off to the institutions to learn, many of the young people remain illiterate, unfortunately. So those things have to be taken into consideration. It's not necessarily the case that the Tibetan culture is increasing their knowledge and education spiritually among the lay people, but more or less in the monastic institutions. Whereas among Chinese, all of the people are literate and willing to want to learn if that is their tendency. And so in my 30-year experience, I have to say that the basic principles of the Buddhist path are what I have emphasized and taught to both cultures. And so that would be renunciation, cultivating bodhicitta, the reasons why this is necessary, as I've described briefly here today, and mainly emphasizing how to realize the identitylessness of self. And so with these as the main curriculum for how we teach, then people are able to develop a qualified education and proceed from there in both cases. Many of the Chinese people do continue to request for Zambala empowerments. That means to be empowered to gain wealth or longevity empowerments so that they can live longer and have a better life. I've never given any of those empowerments. I never intend to. I see no value in it whatsoever. Trying to give someone an opportunity so that they can gain more wealth or live longer in this world so that they can have a happier samsaric life, that's not my goal. I don't spend time doing that because I don't see any positive fruition that would be valuable, a valuable way to spend my time or theirs. And so rather than that, I choose authentic, traditional ways of teaching that will benefit them in the long term, rather than emphasizing something that has no essence.
Shirtungo, ngi samlo tana, huina tansan janaka tani chupa mambozuka, ngimjong da shanchipka sim, dhagme kishtawa la hajan, dorna shi dana tusum gomsun shi kiyaka. Tetan draba changa, tani nafshuka ma tamchika yangna tui tari kua lenji, yojire samka, ngi saru jilun yaha meita. Ngi chiri zini na, ta Amerika la soba go nafshuka, khwerna tari halay ugar kurka, tari alonyi inna draga, ta mayim ba go alayang inna draga, dradang man draba changma da na, tani nga tsu kharshuka, nakjun changma go tani nyamsa langay ta na, sambak chingjir nro tabka ka. Ta maasar yanak mo tamchib samjak chingjir maasipa, nga tsu woyir ka lochong tamchib boga nina, tani tari sambak chingjir songay. Ta nga tsu woyir ka lochong mongboz ka samba da, tani amir ka lochong ka samba wo ka song tsari yon re. Ta ta yinna wog ka tari ka gambo tamchib ka chun da yana, tani nafshuk ka tari ka sambak chingjir song narana. Tani jimtsang ka goga yinna parchir tari ka chigmda shkur bantar kya sangi maari samga yo.
And generally among Chinese, there are many disciples and practitioners who have cultivated genuine renunciation and genuine bodhicitta, compassion. This is something that's really occurring. And although I have limited experience with it, I'm quite sure that that's actually occurring here in the West as well. And from my way of thinking, I was thinking that because the Eastern world likes to imitate many aspects of the Western world, such as the music industry and Hollywood and movie making and so on and so forth, that it's entirely possible that what is happening is the Western world also likes to imitate aspects of the Eastern world. that they can begin to accomplish in their environment, such as the example of the older established Tibetan masters who inspire them. There are some who have said when you come to America, you shouldn't speak about cultivating the bodhicitta, the awakened mind, because this is a country that's based on the premise of achieving personal freedom, and people won't be able to understand that. But whatever the case, it just came out of my mouth, out of my control.